So Boris Johnson met Sue Gray about her report. It's a very simple question, Minister. Who called the meeting? Does a meeting have to be called by anyone? Can't a meeting just be? Who called the meeting? I'm meeting you now. We don't have to know who called the meeting to know that everything's above board. We called you to set up this interview. My point is that as a minister, your diary is full of meetings. We often don't know who we're meeting with, let alone why.
Really?
Yes, unless we're meeting an old friend, in which case it's probably about a contract for PPE. But this was a meeting between a prime minister and the person who was investigating him. So I think it does matter who called it. The prime minister meets his senior civil servants all of the time, even the ones investigating him. Well, yes, otherwise he'd hardly be allowed to speak to anyone. Who called the meeting? It doesn't matter who called it, because ultimately this is an independent investigation by a senior civil servant into the person that she ultimately reports to. And all you're trying to do is create a cloud, a miasma, a stench, a smoke screen.
I'm not trying to do any of those things. I'm just... Oh, hang on. Sorry, I'm just being told that... Yep, number 10 has admitted that they called the meeting.
Which is exactly what I've just been saying. So now you have an answer, let's move on.
So what did they talk about?
Not to that. Did they perhaps discuss photos?
Well, if they did, I'm sure he was just asking her to put a filter on them, something flattering to cover up any blemishes or spots or debauchery, etc.
So he did interfere?
No, the Prime Minister has said that he wouldn't interfere with the investigation. He's on record saying it and has reassured the country that he wouldn't do it. So I, for one, trust him completely.
Just like he went on record and reassured the country that no parties happened in Downing Street, and then was subsequently fined for being at one.
He has apologised for that and accepted the fine, and that's why we should believe him now. It's like that old saying, isn't it? Once you've paid the fine, everything you say is fine.
People are worried that he could be trying to exert pressure on Sue Gray. There's no way Boris Johnson would try and pressure Sue Gray into doing anything.
How do you know that?
Well, for one thing, I don't think he fancies her.
What?
At least no more than he does any sentient woman, which is admittedly quite a lot.
That doesn't mean he can't try to influence her.
Are you questioning Sue Gray's integrity?
No.
Good, because that's my job if her report says anything bad. Thank you, Minister.
Next up, as it's reported that the 222nd richest man in the UK and Chancellor of the Exchequer, Rishi Sunak, spent £500,000 worth of taxpayers' money to find out why people don't like him, we ask, when was the last time you tried to solve a problem and ended up making it much worse?